Welcome, welcome. Glad to have you, virtual crew. Welcome. So as you get set up, we need a set of dumbbells, probably medium of the road weight if you have options. We will do some overhead work, push press, and then dumbbell cleans. That's all we're gonna use dumbbells for today. Everything else is gonna be body weight. Welcome to Quick Fixx. We've got 30-ish minutes of work to do. Again, most of this workout's going to be body weight. My name's Lynne, and I'm excited to have you here. We're gonna kick things off right in the warm-up. You will have some dedicated rest today, but if you need some rest that I'm not providing you, take it and catch up when you're ready. We're gonna repeat things through a number of times. So let's go ahead and get into our warm-up, finding our squat stance. Feet about shoulder distance. We're gonna sit the hips back as we bend the knees. Toes can be pointed exactly forward or they can be pointed out slightly. Mostly, we wanna ensure that the knees and the toes stay aligned. Think about really sitting the hips back and reaching back with the tailbone. Just working in a range of motion that works for you right here at the beginning of class. As the body gets warm, you'll be able to add to your range of motion. Let's do two more here. And then we're going to narrow our stance and go reverse lunges. So feet are going to be right under the hips, stepping back into your reverse lunge. The back knee is going to bend towards the floor. And if you're finding that balance is a challenge here, double check to make sure that your feet are still about hip distance. So thinking feet on train tracks versus a balance beam. That lead knee is gonna be stacked right over the ankle on the lead leg. Looking good, keeping the trunk tall. We'll see more of these today, I promise. One more to each side. Hey Beth, glad you could join. Let's go ahead and find our hand walkout. So feet about hip to shoulder distance. You're going to hinge at the hips. Walk out to a high plank. Once you get to high plank, let's pause there. We're gonna do a push-up. So bend the elbows, bring the body closer to the floor. Exhale up, you can go from the knees if you need to. When you find that high plank, walk hands back to feet. Stand up tall, stack shoulders on hips. Let's do it a couple more times. When you get to your push-up position, thumbs are right in line with the chest. Elbows drive back so your body looks like an arrow at the bottom. Exhale up and return to standing. Let's do another one here. When you find your way to standing, let's move into good mornings. Feet again under the hips, hands behind the ears. Reach back with the tailbone, keeping the spine long. And then stand up tall, shoulders on hips. Looking good, team. Chest stays open and wide. Shoulder blades squeeze together on the backside. In studio, you look great. Get a couple more here. Toes press into the floor as the hips go back. Last two here. Let's widen our stance. We're gonna go back to that squat stance. This time we're gonna sit into our squat and power up to the toes, lifting the heels off the floor. Maybe you can sit a little bit slower into the squat here. Not that's okay, but we're still focused on shifting the hips back or sitting the hips back. And then coming up as tall as possible, extending through the hips, knees, and ankles. Two more here. Now widen the stance if you need to. We're gonna hinge at the hips and grab the toes. Take these into bootstrappers. Sit the hips low with your hands on your feet. Elbows will be inside the knees. And then when you're ready, exhale the hips high for a hamstring stretch and then sink back down again. Work through these two ranges of motion at your own pace. Heels are glued to the floor. So if heels have left the floor, take the feet wider. And do your best to keep the hands as close to the feet as possible if you're unable to hang on to the toes. Couple more seconds here and then we'll return to a lunge. This time I'm going to encourage you to take a forward stepping lunge. When you're ready, you can join me in standing. Feet under the hips again, this time stepping forward. Knee right over the ankle. Back knee still bends towards the floor. If you find this is bothersome to your knee, go ahead and return to that reverse lunge where you're stepping backward earlier. Again, these are all movements we're going to see in our workout today. Sometimes you might just want to return to these as your best option for this Monday afternoon. Looking good in-house. Nice job at home. Good to see so many faces. We're going to get a couple more here, and then we're going to transition this into a lateral lunge. Let's do one more each side. Reset to standing. We're going to step out to the side, wide stance. Shift the hips back, keeping toes pointed forward to the hips. Come back up to standing tall. Switch sides. Looking really good. Press from the outside of the foot as you switch directions on that bent leg. Yeah, good adjustment, Steen. Get a nice stretch on the inner thigh. Couple more seconds here. One or two more to each side. And that's a wrap for the warm-up. Grab some water if you need it. We're going to move into some working sets. We're going to use our dumbbells here. So, our working sets are going to be 20 seconds of work, 20 seconds of rest. We're going to see it three times through. We have two exercises. Your first one is going to be a dumbbell clean. I'll show it from the side. So we're going to take that long spine, shift the hips back, and then we're going to shrug the shoulders and catch the weight right at the shoulders. We'll be there for 20 seconds. Exercise two, push press. From this rack position, we're going to bend the knees and then with power, we're going to dip the hips and press up overhead. Okay? So we do 20 seconds of work, then we rest. Then exercise two, 20 seconds of work, three times through. All right? We go in 10. In 5, 2, 1, here we go. So slight hip hinge, pull the weights up, shrug the shoulders and catch them. If you're like, hey, what is this? Not today. Maybe just go bicep curls. It's okay too, but we still have the same foundation. So feet are still hip distance apart. 2, 1, rest. Nice job. You need to switch out weights here. Do you want to take a different option in our second round to do that? Next one, that's going to be that push press. We'll rack the weight, press overhead. We go in about 10. Grab your weights. 2, 1, here we go. Dip the hips, power up. Using power from the legs and the core to explode the weights overhead. Nothing like losing your microphone in the middle of your lift. 2, 1, time, rest. Round one done. We see that two more times through, so make adjustments where you need to. We see those cleans or curls in 10. This is prep work for the end of our workout. You're welcome. 2, 1, let's go, cleans. So you're extending through the hips, knees and ankles, just like we practiced when we did the squat with a heel lift. Or you're working on your bicep curls. Couple more seconds here. 2, 1, rest. Overhead work coming up next. Good options, team. In 10. It's kind of our extended warm up. Get your rates. 2, 1, let's go. Looking good. Nice full extension. The arms. 5 seconds here. 2, 1, rest. Let's work. 2 rounds down. See it one more time and then we switch gears. At this point, you start to feel the body temp coming up. Maybe the breath is changing a little bit, maybe not too much. It's all right, we'll get it up. 2, 1, last round, let's go. You're shrugging the shoulders if you're in the cleans. You're doing the bicep curls. Elbows are locked in tight, and just the bottom half of the arm is moving. Good options. 2, 1, time. One more exercise, let me switch gears. Push press is coming up. First two rounds have looked really good. 10 seconds. In 5, 2, 1, let's go. Great job, team. Five seconds here. 2, 1, time. Nice job, weights down. Off to the side. We're gonna use our whole box today. So coming up, we have 4 exercises on intervals that we plan on seeing 4 times through. We're down here. First one, I'll show you what the notes say, and then I'll give you some options. Just for 20 seconds, we're going to go 3 jump squats. After your third one, hop forward, back pedal, okay? 20 seconds to do that. Then we have a bear crawl with a plank. So we're gonna get to our tabletop position, hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips, lift the knees, walk out, push up, walk back to your bear. You'll be there for 30 seconds. Then we go into a pendulum switch lunge. I'll teach that to you when we get there. We're gonna alternate between a forward and a reverse lunge. I'll give you all other alternatives as we go as well. Last one, lateral shuffle with a burpee. So we're gonna shuffle down, shuffle back, burpee. All right, 4 times through, you do get some rest in between exercises. We start with 20 seconds of work, 30 seconds of work, 40 seconds of work, 50 seconds of work, then 30 seconds of rest before we repeat the round. Good? All right, we go in 5. First one up, squat jumps to broad jump. 2, 1, here we go. So if you're not leaving the floor, you can just go back to the squat to heel lift. Maybe do that for 3, jog in place for 20 counts. Or you're here, we're halfway, team. Two, 1, time, rest. Now you get a long rest here, it's 40 seconds. Next one up, we're going to see bear crawls with a push-up. You could just do push-ups if you want. You can do push-ups from the knees. So you could walk out, go to the knees, push up, and come back to the bear. We've got 20 seconds, and then we're in. You're gonna want that longer rest as we progress through this workout. Looking good. Get set up. In 5, 2, 1. Lift the knees, walk the hands out. Push up, hands back, bend the knees. We're here for 30 seconds. And here's your halfway mark. Looking good. Core stays tight. Eyes forward of the fingertips. Two, one, time. 30 seconds off. Next one. You can either alternate reverse lunge, alternate forward lunge, or you can follow me where we're going to go reverse lunge, forward lunge, and if you want, jump switch, reverse lunge, forward lunge, jump switch. So we go in 5, 2, 1, here we go. So you can just start in a reverse lunge if you want, or just a forward lunge, or you can follow the pendulum lunge. So it's reverse, forward, jump switch, reverse, forward, jump switch. Nice job. Once you find the hang of it, it flows pretty nicely. It continues to challenge balance. We're here for another 10 seconds. Two, one, time. Nice work. Next one up, shuffle, burpee. You can just do burpees if you want. You can just shuffle if you want. We'll be there for 50 seconds. Find some space. Two, one, let's go. Down, back, burpee. Down, back, burpee. Yeah. Over halfway. Less than 10. Two, one, recover. One round down. How are you doing? You look amazing. We've got 30 seconds and we're back to the top. Make adjustments where you need. If you need me to give you another option, let me know. 15 seconds. Then we're back to the jump squats. Broad jump, reverse. Or you can just stick with the squat to heel lift. We practice that one in the warm up. Going in five. Just 20 seconds of work. Two, one, let's go. We're looking for three squats. Soft landing on the jump, back pedal. Halfway. Quiet landings. Great job. Two, one, time. Shake out the legs. Longer rest here. Let's do that one for 50 seconds. This is zero hands. All right. Looking good in round two. Halfway through our rest. Then we find the bear crawl push-up. 10 seconds. You start in the tabletop position. Two, one, let's go. As we walk back, belly button pulls in. Hips stack exactly over the knees. And the push-up is the same as we did in the warm-up. Thumbs are still in line with the chest. Elbows are still driving back. You have the option to go from the knees or the toes. 10 seconds here. Time. Rest for 30. Lunges are coming up. First round looks so good. If you want to stick with what you did in the first round, do that. If you want to experiment, this is a good place to do that. We have 40 seconds to experiment and practice. And 10 seconds to take off. Lunges. What's that? Lunges. Two, one. Here it goes. A reverse lunge if you're following me. A forward lunge. Switch your feet. Front foot goes back. Reverse. Forward. Switch your feet. Yeah, there we go. Switch. Front leg goes back. Nice. Halfway. Some days, the coordination shows up on these. Some days, not at all. If you feel like it's a challenge, it is. And it's not just you. So close, team. Two, one, time. Next one up, 15 seconds. Shuffling burpees. We're going 10. Fifty seconds of work coming up. 2, 1, shuffle. Burpee. Palms down, fingers forward. Tight core. Nice job, way to stay low. Nice quick feet. Here's halfway. Dig in here, team. You've got this. Longer rest coming up on the other side, 10 seconds. Let's go. Two, one, time. Rounds out. How you doing? At home, how you doing? Awesome. Two rounds out. Two to go. We have 15 more seconds to rest, though. You've got this. We start with squat jumps first. That's quick, though. It's only 20 seconds. Like two and a half reps. 2, 1, let's go. Need the squat to heel lift, take it. Over halfway. Two, one, time. Longer rest here. We'll welcome it. We can go all out for our bear crawl push-ups. Twenty seconds. And we head in. 30 seconds of work. Getting as many as you can. So it's just 30 seconds of work. Best hands out, best hands back. Tight core the whole time. Let's find our tabletop. We go in 5. Hover the knees. 2, 1, let's go. Pull the belly button in tight. Keep your breathing as normal as possible. Easier said than done, right? Over halfway. Bend the knees as you walk the hands back. 2, 1, time. Lunges are coming up next. They really started to come together in round 2. Let's see what round 3 brings. 20 seconds and we work for 40. And 10. Keep in mind all the time that the knee should be stacked over the ankle on the lead leg. 2, 1, let's go. Reverse, step forward, jump switch. Nice job, way to keep the trunk tall. We'll get the pattern down. You can pick up the speed. And again, if you just need to stick to one variation, reverse lunge or forward lunge, do that. We're over halfway. Not every round has to look the same. I just ask that you give your best effort each time we're in the working section. Less than 10. 2, 1, time. 15 seconds. Now I see some shuffles and burpees. 5 seconds. 2, 1, let's go. Palms down, fingers forward on your burpees. Toes pointed forward of your hips and your shuffles.
Great job.
Dig in here, team. 10 seconds. Do your best to stay in motion. Two, one, time. Three down, right? No, it was not four. Nice try. We're gonna do one more round. We go in 10. Squat jumps, broad jump in 5. 2, 1, let's go. Soft landings. All the way through the end. 2, 1, time. That one's done. It's off our list. Nice long rest here. These next three exercises, we get to cross them off when we're done with them. 20 seconds, we see our bear plank with the push-up. It looks really good. Things that make the push-up easier. Keep the core tight. Flex the quads, engage the glutes. Do that whole push-up motion. It definitely helps. We go in 5. Find your bear. 2, 1, let's go. There's some aggressive bears in the house. Big strong effort, you're already halfway. Keep working hard here. Tighten up the core. Nice job keeping the chin out of the chest. 2, 1, that one's off our list. 30 seconds before we head in to our lunges. They just keep getting better. I'm proud of y'all. It's a lot to ask for some coordination on a Monday. Well, we're in the afternoon, it's not like it's 5 a.m. That's my usual teaching time. There's a difference. 2, 1, let's go, 40 seconds. Reverse, forward, switch. You still have the option to just go forward or reverse lunges if that works better for you at this point. Getting some air on those switches. Nice job. Way to dig in here. We're halfway. Nice tall trunks. 10 seconds here. Knees still stacked over the ankle on the lead leg. 2, 1, done with those. That's something to applaud. Shuffles and burpees coming up in 10. In 5. Challenge you to stay as low as you can. 2, 1, let's go. Every day I'm shuffling. Couldn't plan that any better. Nice job, team. As many as you can get here. Here's your halfway mark. Awesome job. Let's go. 20 seconds to work. Last 10. Dig.
Time. Four rounds down. Awesome job, team. Shake up the legs. Catch your breath. Grab some water. We have a short finisher. 90 seconds. You have to take off. You can wipe down your equipment, head out. You can stay for 90 seconds. It'll be worth it. So you can take full advantage of your rest and recovery. For a finisher, very clean and press. So clean, push press. 90 seconds, as many reps as you can get. We go 30. We're gonna combine those two exercises we practiced at the start. 15 seconds till we take off. Getting as many reps as you can. Set. 3, 2, 1. Clock is on. So shrugging the shoulders, weight to the shoulders. Up overhead. That's one. Good. 4. With curl and press. Be mindful about your foundation. Feet are about hip distance apart. Your knees are soft. Core tight. Pull the belly in. Let the hips drive back. Great job, team. Nice job. And you pull. Pull all the way up and catch the weights. Nice, Marissa. Pull it up. Put some power behind it. Nice job. We're over halfway, team. Awesome work. Extension through the hips, knees, and ankles. Less than 30 here. Seconds, let's go. Big effort through the end. Awesome. 2, 1. Nice job. You made it. Took you a couple minutes long. We don't leave any formal time for stretching in the 30-minute format. If you want to hang out, I will walk you through a couple of stretches. You need to take off, just wipe down your equipment and head out. Virtual crew, you were amazing today. So good to have you. Thanks for coming, Beth. Always good to have you. Love having colleagues in my house. Catch your breath, grab some water. I'm going to bring the music down slightly. If you're hanging around for some stretching, let's head it your way. If you're looking for some stretches, which is my recommendation, highly recommend that you get several minutes, 10 plus minutes of stretching, whether it's here or somewhere else. We're not going to take that long together, but I suggest that you get it on your own. Let's start with a quad stretch. Heel to rear, knee points towards the floor. Another great option, 4:30 yoga downstairs with Marissa. Great class. We could double dip. Hang out in here and do some strength with Heather. Strength at 4:30, yoga at 4:30. Let's switch sides. So good to have all of you. Return both feet to the floor. Let's go chest expansion. Interlace the fingers near the tailbone. Press into the palms. Open the chest and the front of the shoulders. Let's reverse it. Upper back stretch. Interlace the fingers in front of the chest. Flip the palms out. Round out the upper back. Pull the belly button in. Stretch that upper back. Bye, Marissa. So glad you made it. Release the hands. Let's go ahead. Take this into a frog squat. So toes can point out here. Nice wide stretch. Set the hips low. We'll take elbows right into the inside of the thighs. And just like we talked about in the warm-up, if your heels have left the floor, go wider with your feet so that they stay glued to the floor.
Let's plant the hands, walk the feet in so that they're under the hips, and nice generous bend in the knees. Let the head hang heavy, belly lay on the thighs. And then tuck the chin into the chest, roll up to standing one vertebrae at a time. Chin will come out last. Let's take a big breath. Inhale the arms up overhead. And exhale. One more. Up. And exhale. Great job today, team. I will be here if you need anything from me. I'll stop the recording so that virtual crew has their opportunity as well. Thank you all. Have a fantastic Monday. Look forward to seeing you later this week.
Thank you, Lynne.
So good to have you. You did great.
I had to come.